First thing I want to show you is this is what many of the attics look like that we go into. And it seems like all the contractors out there just want to do one thing, and that's blow in more insulation. All right. Well, that, if you've got 4 inches of insulation and you can see the top of the joist sticking out of the insulation, you'll probably get a really good benefit from doing that. But even our newest branch manager down in Chattanooga did just that. And after, this was before he came on board with us, it's Wayne down there. And after he did that, he realized, you know, I don't really notice a whole lot of difference spending all that money blowing in an extra 6 inches of insulation. Didn't really seem to help my comfort of my home. And the reason why is because there's more to insulating your attic than just blowing in more insulation, okay? So let's cover some of those things. And I'm gonna show you some problems first. Like the first thing I wanna show you is that we find this a lot in attics. We've got our exhaust coming out of our bathrooms and just dumping hot humid air into the attic. Obviously that can be a problem, eventually leading into mold and different things like that. So if you get up in your attic and you see this kind of stuff right here, this needs to be fixed, all right? So we need to get this either attached to a dryer vent going out of some of the walls of the attic, or maybe even taken to a soffit or even up to the ridge vent. But anyway, we can help you fix that. Here's something else we see a lot. We see a lot of these recessed lights that are covered by insulation. Some of them are IC rated. Some of them are not IC rated. We've got plumbing being covered over by insulation. Nobody even knows it's there. So if you're ever trying to step on things, you got to be careful for this. This is just a safety tip. You don't want to crack that that plumbing line. Now that could be some kind of a drain from HVAC or an exhaust from the plumbing system. We also got boxes that feed into electrical outlets and things like that. So all of this, some of this can be seen with the insulation installed, unless it's not, you know, if it's not very deep. But if you got really deep insulation, these kind of things aren't visible, especially this. This isn't visible. But let's look at what else isn't visible. We've got these chases. These are called chases, where you've got openings around flues from heating and air ductwork or exhausts from water heaters and things like that. These can be dangerous if you don't know they're there. So these should also be air sealed and different things like that. They do have baffles installed, which is great. A lot of times you don't see baffles properly installed, but this can cause updrafts and downdrafts depending on what type of time of year it is. But take a look at this. I want to show you, this is an HVAC duct, and look at how much air is actually leaking from this HVAC duct. Take a look at that. So the AC is running, and you can see the backdraft from that AC duct just blowing that little bit of fiberglass right there. You see all of this just opened up, and they're losing all that conditioned air into the attic. So that's not good, right? So let's look at the next slide here, which is your plumbing system. We see this a lot. We see a lot of these plumbing pipes going down, and look at the gap. Look at the size of that thing. And I just happened to move insulation because I saw this PVC, and I moved that insulation, and look how dirty this pink insulation, look at how black that is. That's from dust and things going up this wall cavity and escaping into the attic, or all of that nastiness in the summertime going down into the living space. And then of course, we've also got all of these penetrations from the electricians trying to figure out where exactly to put the electrical boxes and different things like that. And I don't see where they sealed up any of those holes after they drilled them. So again, this was not something that we could see without removing the insulation. Then you got all of these top plates that are just joined together. Look at that big air gap there. So, you know, if you just go up into the attic hatch and you're looking at a sea of fiberglass or rock wool or cellulose or whatever it is you got up there, you don't notice any of this stuff, all right, which is the point. Adding more insulation is not going to stop the air that's traveling up in all of those things I just showed you. I'm sorry, but insulation is not an air barrier, okay? So the first thing you need to do is remove the insulation. Now, this is a video of how we remove insulation. This is a vacuum. If you want to do this yourself, you can probably rent these insulation vacuums from, you know, like your United Rentals or your Sunbelt Rentals or things like that. These are insulation vacuum bags. That's a 6-inch line going up into the attic. And we got a ninja up in the attic sucking out all that fiberglass and pulling all that out so that we can dispose of this insulation and show you what we would do next. All right, so look at what we do next. After you remove the insulation, step two is you want to air seal the floor of the attic. Look at all of these spots in this different, these are two different attics. This, we put some can-like covers over, these insulite covers over over IC-rated can lights. Now, if you have a non-IC-rated can light, we recommend you use a different kind of cover. But this one was okay, so we air sealed this, made sure that we had it to where the insulation could blow up to the can light. As you can see, several of them were installed over here. This was all air sealed. We air sealed all the top plates, all of the joints, anywhere where there was any kind of electrical or exhaust fan or things like that. So that is number two, you want to air seal. The second step is to create a dam around those areas where you want to keep the insulation from falling. This, as I mentioned before, is a baffle. You want to make sure you have baffles installed everywhere around where the soffit vents are so that the air can travel up into the attic so that you don't build up moisture and things like that. You also want to create a dam around your attic hatch covers. This, I think we used a 2x10 right here so that we could get enough of a height to blow in this insulation so that we had plenty of insulation around the attic hatch cover. A lot of attic hatch covers, when you go up there, there's no insulation around them and they're not air sealed, okay? So you wanna make sure you do that. This was a tray ceiling that we had to build a dam around so that we could blow insulation on top of the tray ceiling after we air sealed it. This was a storage platform up in an attic. Again, we used our foam board, built an attic around it. You can see we also installed radiant barrier in this attic, and we blew in insulation all around there. Now, a lot of contractors, they'll just blow insulation and let it fall on these areas and lose that R value. So you want to make sure you got somebody that's building these dams for you. Then, after you do that, then you want to seal your attic hatches and your can lights. Okay, now we showed in the previous slide where we used a different kind of insulite barrier to seal those can lights. This is a really cool little product that you can also use. This has got a radiant barrier around it. You could probably locate these guys on Amazon if I remember correctly. So this just slides right over the can light. I believe this can be used for non-IC rated can lights as well as IC rated. Now that means non-insulation contact versus insulation contact. All right. But if you've got a non-IC rated can light cover and you change out with an LED light, you should not be producing a whole lot of heat in that can light. So you should be okay there as well. But check the manufacturer specs for heat gain and loss in those lights. But look at this. This is a custom made attic hatch cover that we had to build to air seal right here. It's beautiful. This was done by Mulu. If you've ever seen any of him in our videos, he did a great job air sealing this with our foam board, just created a custom made attic hatch cover right there. You can also use our ones that we got at our DIY store available. We got some pre-made radiant barrier attic hatch covers you can purchase as well. And then lastly, the last thing you want to do after you get all these things sealed up, maybe throw in some radiant barrier if you decide to do that, is you want to blow the insulation back in. Now, again, if you're a DIYer, you can do this yourself. Make sure you got the baffles. Here's some radiant barrier installs. You want to make sure in our climate is at least an R38, but we recommend R49. The other thing you want to make sure of is that you follow the directions. You don't want to turn on that blower to where it's blowing in a lot of air into especially fiberglass. You don't want to like whip it. Okay, if you've ever had a whipped cream cheese versus regular cream cheese, it's more frothy and airy. all right, and lighter. So that's something a lot of contractors will do, is they'll blow a lot of air into that insulation, so they use half the amount of bags recommended. So that's a little trick you got to pay attention to. Make sure that you look at the bag. And if you're blowing in R38, it should tell you how many bags per square foot you need, and make sure that contractor blows in all of those bags to make sure that your attic is properly insulated. A little bit harder to fudge cellulose, because cellulose is so much more heavy and dense, but with fiberglass, it is really easy to cheat you on how much insulation they put in your attic. So make sure you're hiring a trusted contractor to do this, or if you're doing it yourself, obviously, That's a no-brainer. You can regulate that. So my name is Michael Church with Crawl Space Ninja. Again, help us to expand and grow in your area. God's really blessing us, and we're looking for more leaders out there to help us grow these branches. And we're fixing attics, basements, crawl space, and duct ceiling. And my name is Michael Church. Hope you make it a happy and blessed day, and we'll see you later.